Welcome to the Archer's Friend production of the latest upgrades to the Mantua Range in Mantua, Utah. That's the Mantua Gun Range, that is. It belongs to the Box Elder Wildlife Federation, otherwise known as BEWF.org for the website. And start out by saying my heavy hauler there. It's an old 96 Dodge with a 12-valve Cummins engine in it. Probably the best engine ever made by man for the average person. Too bad the green weenies and the government has forced Dodge and Cummins to change that engine, because they should have left it alone. Best thing ever what was. Best thing since sliced bread, and then they've screwed it up. Well, you can see a little range here. Every year we make a few more improvements on it. We've got the covered shooting line. You saw the storage tool shed back there, the pink one. And then beside that we have a great big outhouse type thing for a restroom. Short range berm of dirt that we're working on today. It's for the handgun shooters and the hunter's ed class. Got this little forklift here for my tractor that we use to move things around. We got a bunch of railroad ties donated to us by the state, and they're old antique ones, not even creosoted, so we're using those to hold that dirt, berm of dirt up. That little shot of the going up the canyon there with the street sign is the Sardine Canyon, and a few miles on up that road is Logan, Utah. This is our cowboy action shooter stations over on the left, so that they'll be up close to the back stop impact area. And this is our underground bunker. We got a nice big hole up here. What we did that for was storage for targets and stands and stuff down inside under that slab that you see there on top. Then you walk down into that pit so the target setters and scorers can be safe. And you can see the back toward the south there is the Mantua Lake. Still got snow on the peaks, and those peaks are, you know, between 8,000-9,000 feet tall, so they still gonna have snow for quite a few days yet. This is a big dirt pile from the excavation of that pit for the 100 meter target area. It's a slow process, but fortunate enough to have acquired for my personal use this John Deere 4300 tractor loader backhoe to use around my place and donate labor and time and stuff to the range and help build just about everything up there as far as the building part goes. I wasn't here when that bunker was built, but the slab for the shooting pad and everything else it was. You know, you stack up these railroad ties. There's several of them tall, and we got three deep to keep hold that berm up. If we didn't do this or have something there, it'd take over four times as much dirt, because it just won't stack up enough without using lots and lots of dirt. So we just take it a little at a time, dump it in there, and try to compact it a little bit with the bucket and get the sides to where it don't slide off when it gets some wet weather, and keep on working till we get it up the way we want it. And the reason I had to come up here is about the top foot or so was shot up with bullets and stuff, so we need to repair that hole. This gravel, this gray stuff, is not really gravel. It's a man-made gravel, I should say. It's really slag from the, it's a byproduct from the making iron or steel trusses by the Nucor plant that's a few miles up toward the Idaho border. Works real good. It's inexpensive for plate and dirt. Kind of help you keep from getting stuck during the winter and wet season. And another plus for that stuff, if you put it on a pole barn or something where you don't have a slab, bugs and mice don't like to crawl across it, so that's kind of a plus area. And we have a little walkway up to that short berm of dirt where people can walk up without getting their feet too muddy. And during the winter, the snow plow got a little off the roadway and created some ruts for people trying to get in there, so I'm going to go ahead and patch that up. We got an extra pile of gravel there. Thought I may as well straighten that mess up while I'm up here and smooth it out a little bit and fix it so next winter it won't be so bad. All done, and get a little 4300 loaded up and go play a little bit at the range. You can see I take a little opportunity to do a little shameless advertising, the archersfriend.com site, and got some of those ruts, or most of the ruts I should say, smoothed up and holes filled, and got a little gravel left for the next project if need be. And you can see we're a couple hundred yards off of the main city street. We are just in the city limits of Mantua, Utah, but this range has been here for a long, long time, so the subdivision finally built out to us, but they just have to put up with our shooting. This is our storage building, and we got a sign to thank the NRA for the help with the funding of our projects. We got cement shooting stations and some wood ones. And there's my old Henry 22 and my brand new Judge, Taurus Judge, I haven't shot yet, but I'm fixing to fix that problem. Little high point 9mm for an inexpensive 9mm to play around with. And while we were up here, there was a rock chuck, groundhog, or some kind of a varmint came out of the rocks. We'll get a shot of that in a minute. I'd like to thank Roberts Heating and Air Conditioning for helping us get this insulation and these tack ties up there to put them on the roof. It really cuts down on the noise and makes it easier to stand it when you're up there shooting. Now that rock chuck is up about 12 o'clock off of that rock, that little white rock that's in that curve, and to the south about 11:30 or so of that pole that's way up there. And probably you can see it, but I'm not real sure, but he's almost 12:30 off of that rock, right about the center of that grass, and then down about 11:30 off of that pole that's farther up. You might be able to see him. Well, the little video clip I'm watching as I'm making this, hard to say. And we thank you for watching, and as usual, invite you to go to our website and take a look at our other videos and subscribe to help us out. Thank you, and as our usual, we'd like to say see you in the mountains and come back soon.